Hey mom, what are these weird boxes? I've never seen them before. We usually have different boxes than these. Honey, they're just new boxes, okay? Okay then. Well, I guess I'll start packing. Alrighty. Better pack quick because the house is ready for us. Okay. My dumb stuff packed. This will be the boringest day of my life. After packing everything. Umbreon, be careful back there.
I will, Mom. Jeez, you're so overprotective.
I just don't want you getting hurt. Jeez, you don't understand. Mom, can you just go? Please. Yes, sweetie, we'll go now. Okay, thank you. Alrighty, let's go.
By the way, we found the survivor in that car accident. It wasn't a car accident, by the way. Somebody took the car off. The mom and the son.
The daughter's the only survivor. Shall we bring her in your office?
Yes, get me, get them, get her in my office now.
Oh, so you're the survivor of the car crash. It wasn't a car crash. Some weird possessed man came and murdered my family. I didn't see what he looked like, but I'm sure somebody's gonna want to talk to me, so I better not spill the beans already. Well, are you here for therapy too?
No, they just wanted to investigate me. Oh, they have a therapy room. My mom died a few days ago. She passed away. We haven't held a funeral yet, but if you'd like, you could participate. I'd love to. If I'm free. Alrighty. See you later. See you too.
How'd you know my name?
I can just tell. Alrighty, Missy, let's get going. You have a lot of explaining to do.
What? Ow.
Alrighty, sit up here. You have a lot of explaining to do.
What you've done is unacceptable.
What did I do?
No.
Why would I ever hurt them in any way? I love them. Why would I hurt my family?
Because you're insane, that's why. And you know.
This doesn't make any sense. Can you just let me go?
No. No one's going in that van and getting your stuff either. Because you're going to live here, at this station.
I'm not living in a police station.
Oh, yes, you are.
You're living in our basement.
Just because of what you've done, it's unthinkable.
I didn't do what I promised. We don't take promises, Missy. For my information, we know you did it. There's no such thing as that happening, okay? So, yeah, you're staying in our basement, and that's gonna be your home. You're hardly gonna have anything of a bed, food, water, anything you need. Shelter. That's it.
That's not fair.
Just saying.
there's going to be somebody else down there pretty soon, too. So, you might want to get along with her. With him. You better not do anything. Ew, you're disgusting. Just let me go, you sicko. Did you call me a sicko? I'm not a sicko. I'm doing this for your own good. To trap me away from the world? Do you want me to come out and be insane? Sure, why not? I'll just keep you in there longer. You don't make any sense. Why would I... Shut up. You know, I am the president of this town and I can do what I want with it. Means I can do whatever I want with you and you can't do anything about it. Except for be smart and leave this place. Where do you think you're going? Will Sylveon be free, or will she stay? Stay tuned for the next episode and you'll find out yourself.